Mr. Pablo, I think Mr. Hindoi would be a while. Are you sure you want to still wait?
Rahul, just shut the fuck up. Honestly, I woke up at 6:30 a.m. this morning, drove my taxi here, not to talk to you, but to talk to Mr. Hindoi, who doesn't appear to be here.
Hey, speaking of taxis, how long have you had yours for?
You just noticed I had the taxi. Oh my god, you stupid, stupid, idiot talking caribou. I've had Jugnu since I was 6 years old.
Tell me how you met your taxi.
Oh, fucking fine. Not like I've got nothing better to do. Beep, 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 beep. It was 1948. I was a young boy walking the streets with my mother until we walked past a taxi dealership.
Mommy, mommy, I want this taxi. Beep, beep.
Excuse me, sir. How much is this taxi?
Yeah, we're talking about $939 here. Fuck.
Oh no, that's expensive. Come on, Pablo.
Mom, no! Don't walk away from it! No!
I cried for days, weeks, months. I was so depressed, I threatened to kill a child in my class. I still remember that day. The kid's name was Norton. He was a gay fucking cunt. He asked me why I looked sad. I punched him in the face, grabbed a sharp pencil, and pointed it at his head. The teacher stopped me, so I had to go see the school psychiatrist about my depression. Until one day, towards Christmas time, me and my mother walked past the same taxi dealership, and the same man was there. I begged my mom to go in there again, so she went in.
Oh, it's you two again. Yeah. Thinking about buying the taxi again, are ya?
No, my son just wants to look around.
I'll tell you what, missy. If you give me something, I'll give you the taxi for free, no charge.
Oh, really? Okay, what would you like?
I would like you to come over to my place right now so I can fuck you so hard your brains fall out.
I could see it in my slut of a mother's eyes, she was getting turned on. All of us got into the car, dearest car, and drove to his apartment. I sat there for 30 minutes watching silly cartoons on television, until I heard my mother screaming in the next room. She was screaming in pain and agony. Ooh, and ahs all around.
Oh, yeah. Oh, God.
I walked in on my mother and the car dealer. Fuck it.
We're just wrestling Pablo, sweetie.
The car dealer gave us the taxi for free, but I told my father what I saw. My father was someone you would never want to piss off. You see, he was the mob boss of the Indian Mafia. When he heard about this, he beat my mother and went over to the car dealer's apartment and killed him with a pistol. Shot him through the head. But there was a witness. Turns out my father forgot to shut the door when he barged in, and someone who lived in the apartment saw the whole thing go down and identified my father. My mother, who had now learned my father was in the Indian Mafia, was very angry. One night, they had a physical fight.
I hate you, you motherfucker!
You fucking slut! Come here! Come here, you bitch! My father pulled out his weapon to scare her. My mother punched him in the face, grabbed the weapon, and shot my father multiple times in the stomach. My mother was laughing her ass off until she realized what she had did was no better than what father did. Mother said to me,
Pablo, we have to go away now. We have to go someplace far.
We stopped off at school to pick up my brother Eduardo early. Mother told him the news in the car, and he said that.
That cunt got what he deserved.
I was too young to comprehend what happened that day. But over the years, bits and pieces made sense. We eventually made it to Iowa. I stayed there until I finished high school. That was also the last time I saw my mother and brother. So that, Rahul, is how I met my taxi!
So where's the happy ending?
There is no happy ending. It's a true story.
What sort of story has no happy ending?
A story that isn't happy to begin with.
I like stories that are happy.
Yeah, well, too bad, Gunt. Mr. Hindawi, you're back. And about time to...
Pablo, quickly, call Sanji and Rajesh. Tell them it's urgent.
Mr. Hindawi?
No, Pablo, no! I'll tell you what's going on after you call them.
Okay, fuck.
Mr. Hindawi, what's going on?
A cliffhanger, Rahul. A very long cliffhanger.